fun, actually.
See, that's what I'm talking about. Mm. Big sound, big confidence.
Mm-hmm. We're sassy, we're sexy, we're larger than life.
What are we?
Absolutely fabulous!
So next step's got to be our own gig, a proper venue.
Mm, with stage outfits, something sparkly.
You really think we're ready?
Of course we are. There's no one like us out there. We're living, breathing, singing proof that big is beautiful.
On me. We've got to keep our weight up.
Don't worry about it, it's fine. I'll get a cough.
Oh, what a mess.
Oh, what a waste. More like, we'll get you another one.
I need to go.
Okay. See you tomorrow then.
Well, learn your lyrics this time.
Ah, chocolate ice cream. Better than sex.
Watch out.
Do you think Sue's okay?
She's more than okay. She's absolutely fabulous. I'll be back in a sec.
Dr. Cassidy will call you. Can I help you?
Tembe! Desperately seeking one receptionist. Any ideas?
I am taking control of my working environment. Please, take a seat. Surely you have read that there is a new strain of influenza coming to this country. There are so many sick people here. I do not want to be infected.
It's a doctor's surgery.
I completely see your point, but is keeping them at arm's length really the answer? The human body is a marvellous piece of machinery. The more it's exposed to threats, the stronger it gets.
Are you saying I should expose myself?
Build up your immunity. I mean, look at me. A picture of health.
He did not.
With a bit of ketchup.
Simon, about yesterday, I was out of order.
Yeah, you were.
You make me feel uncomfortable, I don't blame you.
Daniel, I've got nothing to say to you.
Can you help me out?
No.
Nurse Malone, I would really appreciate a word at your convenience.
Yeah, sure, I've got a minute now, come in.
May I request a modicum of privacy, please? Can I be of assistance?
No.
Well, no. Do you have an appointment?
Sorry, I can't.
Diane!
Hi, lovely to see you. Oh. So how's life treating you?
Fine, thanks.
Good. Right, so what can we do for you then?
Well, I just... Look, now's not a good time. Maybe I'll come back. Sorry.
Oh, you have got skin.
What do you think you are doing? You are frightening the patients.
I am merely taking sensible precautions. What is so frightening about that?
Why don't you ask Diane Gresham? Because that poor lady is phobic about coming in here, and now that she has, she's confronted with...
Hannibal Lecter.
If people cannot cope with appropriate medical attire, it is not my problem. Karen is away. What if I get infected? What happens then?
Nothing happens then if you keep that thing on, because we won't have any patients.
Mrs. Parsons, this is a health and safety issue. I have the right to protect myself.
From what exactly? An aggressive attack of sneezing? Mrs. Tembe, I am sorry. I absolutely must insist.
Of course.
Thank you.
Just tell Karen that, Just tell her that I called again. Yeah, yes, again. Yeah. No, I've got to go. Thanks. Bye, son. Thanks for coming.
You okay? Something happened with Mum?
Oh, let's face it. I'd be the last to find out. I mean, it's not that I'm not used to the silent treatment, but this time it's long distance. I'm running out of excuses for your granddad.
She said she doesn't want him to worry.
You spoke to her?
Last night. She was a bit off, didn't want to talk about, you know.
Did she ask about...
Said everything was fine.
Oh, yeah, it is. Never better. And now DCI drivers decided to help me out by seconding me on a nobo the other side of the county. Nights.
Mrs. Tembe, did you know that recent research suggests that masks are not 100% effective in germ warfare?
Really?
Well, this is the best antibacterial gel on the market. Kills all germs on contact. Stone dead.
That is fascinating, Dr. Clay. I may use this gel.
What did I tell you?
I have never been so disgusted.
Don't stop me! Don't stop me! Don't stop me, have a good time.
Oh, sorry, Bex. We just lost it there. I'm sorry. Me too.
No, it's okay. I bet even Beyonce gets the giggles. That's what rehearsals are for. Diane, watch your vocals. It's ooh, not ah. Yeah. And Sue, you missed your cue. Try and keep up. Right, from the top, come on. Unless anyone's got a problem with that.
I was late back to work twice last week. I just need to watch the time.
Look, success is 1% inspiration, 99% perspiration.
99% delusion, am I right?
If we're going to make a go of this, you have got to take it seriously, right? Let's out-sing Girls Aloud. Let's out-sex the Pussycat Dolls. We'll put our own stamp on it. We can do anything. Who are we?
We're absolutely flabulous.
You're so sure about everything, aren't you? We just snap our fingers and the future falls into place.
Sue?
Well, it's just a bit of fun. I didn't think things were going to get this far.
Well, think again, girlfriend. We're on our way. Come on!
Can we call it a day?
Oh, look, we haven't even eaten yet. I'm starving.
I could eat. Mm. Oh.
Well, that new pizza place has opened.
We should go sometime.
Yeah. Oh, the Queen's visiting Leatherbridge.
Her Majesty? The Queen in Leatherbridge?
Yeah, that's what it says. She's visiting the Houseman ward.
When?
Next week, apparently.
Oh.
Mrs. Tembe, I think we should sit down. You're overheating and take some
Her Majesty.
Breaths.
The Queen. I cannot believe it. Our own esteemed monarch here in Leatherbridge. Is this not the greatest of honours?
Oh, they're stuck in a time warp, if you ask me. Except maybe Charles. He's flown the flag for organic farming, I suppose.
I presume you are talking about Prince Charles. Prince of Wales, heir to the throne.
I can't wait for Prince William to get married. They really know how to put on a show.
Centuries of tradition is not putting on a show. I cannot believe what I am hearing.
here.
Oh, cheers for that. Mm. I was frantic till I got your message. Yeah. Just about to cancel my sim again. There's one missed call on there from me. I just wanted to see if you were okay last night. Diane, you worry too much. But thanks. Look, we could tell each other anything, right?
What's brought this on?
Nothing.
Oh, I get it. You've sussed my guilty secret. Even you've got to admit she's like a cheerleader on speed sometimes. Brings out the worst in me.
Come on, let's talk in the car.
Actually, I think I'll walk. Get some fresh air.
Oh, okay. Tonight at the Icon, then.
See you, Spex.
What's up with the voice of doom? Honestly, she couldn't get out of here fast enough. Talk about negative energy. Absolutely flabulous. Just a bit of fun. Well, I'll show her. I'm going to get on the phone right now and swing that headline slot.
Oh, can't you just shut up about Ab Flab for 1 minute?
Emma? Imogen! It's Jack.
It's nothing personal. I'm a Republican. All men created equal.
The Queen is not a man.
Oh, come on. Does anyone give a damn about the royal stuff anymore? The crown jewels might be worth a couple of quid, but beyond that...
You are all the same.
Oh, no, we are not all the same.
No, we're not.
Don't ask.
Surely there must be someone who has respect for the duty, the status of the crown.
Funded by millions in civil list payments while we're in a recession and the NHS goes down the pan. The royal family are a bunch of spoilt, inbred, incompetent parasites who live in gilded palaces with silver spoons stuffed in their mouths. I told you not to ask.
I see. Well, if no one else is going to stand up for the Queen, I must do it myself. Oh, Mrs. Parsons, I need to request a day off Monday next week.
What, with Karen away? Is it important?
Monday is Valentine's Day, and Mrs. Temby is head of the...
The Queen is visiting.
What, do you need the whole day? All right, then. Anything but Queen and country.
Thank you.
Royalist, are you now, Julia? Realist. Anything to get a mind off that wretched...
I can see that you're concerned, but honestly, I can't discuss patients. But you're best friends, can't you ask her yourself?
I've been trying. But there's something different. I don't know, a barrier. That's why I know it must be something terrible.
Well, she's lucky to have you as a friend. You even braved the mill for her.
Okay, I can take a hint. Subject closed.
So while you're here, we could get started on the well woman check. We're offering it to everyone, it's just a routine thing.
Routine? In what way?
Blood pressure, maybe a urine test. We can have a chat about lifestyle.
Lifestyle, you're calling it now, are you? What you mean is you're going to give me a lecture on my weight?
No, not at all. Not if you're happy the way that you are.
Just couldn't resist, could you? Well, I am happy. I'm absolutely flabless, in fact. But that's got nothing to do with why I'm here.
Oh, look, I was hoping to catch you with the two. I know I've been a cow.
Oh, it's fine.
Nice and early. Taking things seriously at last. Well, have I got news for you. Follow me. I made a few calls, chased a few contacts, and I got us a headline slot. You are not going to believe it.
That's great, Bex. So where?
Only the High Note Club.
In Birmingham? Oh, you've got to be joking. We can't sing that.
Someone's pulled out. Fate or what? I know it's short notice, but if we put the rehearsal time in, I sold the manager our image, played him our demo. He absolutely loves us.
How short notice?
This Saturday.
No way.
Hey, what happened to the positive mental attitude?
We can't possibly.
Look, we've got a set list, more or less. You know, we just need to up our rehearsal time, get the costumes sorted. Come on, this is it, our big break. We're not just doing it for ourselves. We're trailblazers for the beauty of the bigger woman. Am I right?
I can't do it, Max.
Oh, I'm sorry. You need to find someone else.
Well, I don't get it.
Don't let me spell it out.
Well, could you spell it out? Because I don't understand. What could be so terrible that you pull out now?
The doctors? Soon.
Where's Dad?
One another. Nights. It's not sure ever.
Oh, great. So that's two parents that have done a runner now. Twice.
Hardly a runner. Anyway, I'm in there. Keep an eye on things.
Boss me about, you mean? Don't even start.
Like this was my idea, Dad asked me.
Asked you to come here and stuff your fat face full of all the food, did he? Where is my tea?
If you even bothered to come out of that room of yours.
It is my room and it's my house and you don't live here anymore.
Do you think I want to be here with a stroppy, ungrateful cow like you?
Well, do us all a favour then and bog off.
Treatments are really good these days. My auntie had cancer and she's doing great.
I'm sure I'll be fine.
Just sorry to leave you two in the lurch.
Well, the important thing is we know now, so we can make a plan.
Stupid to think you wouldn't notice. I have lost a bit of weight and it's probably going to get worse.
Sickness.
Yeah.
Not to mention stress. Well, you're not on your own anymore. How often do you need to go to the doctors?
It's a kind of monitoring process at the moment, with tests and stuff.
Once a week?
Well, I'll go with you every week.
Oh, but...
What are friends for?
Oh, you'd really do that. I'm so sorry about Absolutely Flabulous. I never thought things would get so big so fast.
Well, it's not the best timing, but the dream doesn't have to die. As long as you feel well enough to sing, we can make it work. It's not forever, and there's ways to bring you back up to size.
Surely you're not suggesting...
Nobody's saying fat suit. But just a bit of padding here and there. Strategic places.
That'll never work. Just find someone else.
No, we're all in this together. It's going to take more than this to split up Absolutely Flabulous.
As though we'd drop you just like that.
No, really?
And anyway, it's only temporary. As soon as your treatment's over, we'll have our old Sue back again as large as life.
Oh, you're such great mates. I can't believe I'm...
You had your reasons, but that's in the past.
But... No, it's our big, fat, singing future that matters now. We'll start rehearsals tomorrow. Ab Flab are back on track and we're bigger than ever. Ab Flab! Cheers! To fatties everywhere.
I will be there for six.
Six? 6 a.m.?
I will take provisions as the day will be long. I will secure a good position outside St. Philomena's to get a good glimpse of Her Majesty. I will, of course, offer flowers something small, but elegant.
If she comes close, she may shake your hand.
Oh. If I thought there was even a chance.
Why leave things to chance? What if someone could get you on the official receiving line to meet Her Majesty in person?
Oh, Dr. Carter.
I have a few friends at St. Phil's. I could call in some favours. You're just the sort of ambassador who should meet the Queen.
Are you sure you are not making fun of me?
My dear lady, of course I can't guarantee anything. But leave it with me. I'll make some inquiries.
Oh. It's Granger Danger. He just turns on the charm and expects you to be putty in his hands. Don't you fall for it.
Maybe I should.
No, you shouldn't. Don't you dare.
Oh, hello. Thought it was you. Oh, look. I want to apologise for the way I spoke to you earlier.
Don't worry about it. Like I say, my door's always open.
Actually, you might be seeing a lot more of me. I'm going to come along with Sue to her appointments. You know, support her.
Oh, good for you.
Listen, I'll head off, leave you to it. Oh.
You know, Sue's really helped me put things in perspective. She's the brave one. Can't believe she kept it to herself for so long.
Oh, she was worried about how you take it, but now you know, it's no big deal.
Maybe like really big headdresses and draw the audience's eyes up.
Moulin Rouge style, nice one.
Sue?
It's not what you think.
What am I thinking? I wish I knew.
What's going on? Sue?
So, why can't you tell them?
I can't. Oh, all right. There's no cancer. I haven't got cancer! It's something worse.
What?
You don't know them! I've lost weight and it's not because I've been ill or anything. I've been on a diet.
Well, that's no big deal, is it?
Mm-hmm. Cherry's given me loads of advice. I couldn't have done it without her.
Well, it's your own willpower. You've done amazingly well.
So, you're not ill. You haven't got cancer?
No.
You've just been on a diet.
Oh, come on. We're supposed to be best mates. It's a good thing, isn't it?
Hollings House of Ale. Hi, Emma. Yeah? It's all good. Hold on. Imogen! No, really, everything's great. Couldn't be better.
Call yourself a friend? How could you?
I was about to tell you. Panicked.
Was it so hard to tell us the truth?
I know how you feel about yourself. Good, right? Happy being big.
How's it all about personal choice?
Oh, spare us the sermon. I swim a mile 3 times a week and I go to Pilates. Why can't you see me, not my weight?
Why can't you see me?
So Sue made a different choice, that's all.
Oh, please. We're talking pure betrayal. Cancer, well, that's one thing. But you deliberately jeopardised the success of AbFlab.
It just didn't feel right anymore. I wasn't happy.
Come on, so she cut down on a few calories. She didn't kill anybody. She needs her friends.
Oh, her friendship's looking pretty dead to me right now. Everything AbFlab stands for obviously means nothing to you.
Surely you're not asking to choose, that's not fair.
Well, isn't the choice already made? Well, we'll carry on without you, won't we, Diane? Come on, let's go.
Bog off.
She's just coming, Mum.
Mum's on the phone.
I don't see why you can't be a band of average-sized singers. You didn't do the Sugar Babes anyhow.
Oh, yeah, right. Then what will make us special?
We are special. Look, we love you, but sometimes it seems it's our weight, not us you want around you.
Well, I've never heard such absolute rubbish.
Prove it, then. Because if Sue's out the band, I'm out too.
OK, fine. But don't think you can come crawling back when your calorie counting goes belly up. You're both fired.
Oh, can't we just...
I hope you and Nurse Fat Fascist here are very happy together. Excuse me, I've got a gig to cancel.
He just loves coming here and bossing me about.
No, Mom, he didn't. He just made himself a massive feat. When I asked him, he just kicked off on one.
Losing weight feels right for me. Yeah. Even if it doesn't mean my showbiz days are numbered.
Hang on, I don't see why it has to be all or nothing. Singing or slimming, surely there's another way.
You have met Bex, right?
Well, I may be wrong, but she doesn't seem like the sort of person that'd give up just like that. Not if she's got a shot at the big time.
And Dream doesn't have to die.
Anyway, I better be going.
See you next week.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll pop by sometime too. Not for a diet, but you're right. I should get my blood pressure and that checked out. Cherry?
Hmm?
Will that scary woman be there? The one in the mask?
Oh, thanks!
Yeah, like you care.
We can make this work.
Yeah, if you've got Beth Ditto on speed dial.
I've got someone better. Me! So I'm losing weight, but I'm not going to be Britain's Next Top Model by Saturday. There's no reason why I can't play the high note.
We'd love it to be that easy.
Well, it's not.
I can't tell you how sorry I am for lying to you and Diane. It's the worst thing I've ever done, but I can't take it back either.
She proper messed up. She knows that.
But don't let it mess up our friendship. Or Ab Flab. Not now. I'll stay till you get a replacement you both like.
So you're still...
The diet stays, but... Please don't stop the, please don't stop the, please don't stop the music!
No, go on!
Mama say, mama say, mama say, mama say, mama say, mama say, mama say,
to explore the culture of being at one with oneself.
I don't like hugging trees.
I gave you a £20 note.
No, you've had your change.
I know what I had in my purse.
She's just conned you out of £10.
You need to see someone about that temper of yours.
And those shoes look stupid with your fat ankles.
I'm going to try and pass on to you some simple skills which will allow you to be a happier person.
Love and betrayal in a brave new world.